Hi there, my name is Sean Jordison, and in this video, we are going to convert a PDF into a Word document so that we can copy and paste our text out into a new Canvas page. The first step that we want to do is open our document. I have a document open here called Energy. Now, we are going to pretend that I cannot copy and paste the text out of my file here. So what I'm going to do is select the File button, select Export to Microsoft Word, Word document. I'm going to save this file on my desktop. And it did a nice job of converting this file over to a Word document. Now what we're going to do is get this content into a new Canvas page. Let me rearrange my windows a bit here. I am opening up a new Canvas page here, and I am going to title this Energy. In my Word document, I'm gonna select Control A on my keyboard for select all. Then I'm gonna select Control C to copy, or we could right click, copy. Then go to your Canvas page, and I'm going to Control V or right click paste. Now it looks like most of our content went through. I am not focused on editing right now. I simply want to get my content over. It looks like my image didn't quite move over. We are going to screenshot our image using the snippet tool. So I'm going to use the snipping tool. Come in here, grab this image, then save it to my desktop, and then we can come over here and upload this image. Throw that in. Give it some alternate text. This is just a placeholder for now. I will need to come back in and add more alt text and click submit. Then we select save and we have a good looking document. Let's go ahead and make this page accessible. First, we're gonna select the edit button and I wanna pull up my Word document so I can quickly reference it. This looks like one of the top headings here. So we're gonna make this section a heading level 2. And let's open the document once more. You are the voice. Okay, this seems like just base text. Now our image doesn't appear to quite go there. I think for this particular example, it's gonna be the last item on the page. So we are going to drag this image around and move it under our final bullet point. And some background information kind of looks like it should be a heading level 3. I like to delete blank spaces out. And we have a couple spaces with our list items that I'm going to simply remove. We can verify our content is in a list by selecting the list. And looking at the little icon here, it appears to be selected. From here, this is where we need to add some better alternate text to our image. So to add alternate text, I'm going to select the image, select image options, and we have our alt text over here on the page. Okay, I have written out a detailed alternate text, but I feel like this is too long of a description to include in the alternate text. So what I'm going to do is copy this information that I wrote, and I'm going to delete some of this out of the alt text and simply add it underneath my image. We have a little bit of formatting cleanup to do. Okay, so here we have once more our alt text, which is US energy consumption by energy 2009. And then underneath the image, we have a detailed alternate text of the specific data points. This is a good way to get all of our content on the page and ensure that it remains accessible. If we wanted to, we could add a figure description, something like this, US energy consumption description, something like that. And we would give this a heading, maybe a heading level 3. And then if we had the source for this document, we would come right up here and say something along the lines of, this content was created in reference by, and then we would list out the document source, and we could link that to the source. We should verify the accessibility of our page by checking the Check Accessibility button and making sure that we have no errors.